In this video, we are going to learn how to draw Lewis structure for a molecule in 5 simple steps. Here are some of the other names Lewis structures are called by. Before we begin going through the steps, let me just caution you that you will need to follow the steps in sequence. If you jump steps, most likely your Lewis structures will not turn out right. We're going to work with sulfur dioxide in this video. Step 1. We'll need to calculate the total number of electrons we're going to work with by adding up all the valence electrons for all atoms in the molecule. Sulfur has 6 valence electrons, and oxygen has 6 valence electrons. But since there are 2 of the oxygen, we'll need to multiply it by 2. And this gives us 18 electrons to work with. Step 2. We're going to write the chemical symbol of the atoms in a molecule and then connect the atoms with 2 electrons representing a single bond. Note that the atom in the center is called the central atom, while the atoms at the ends are called terminal atoms. So how do you know which atom to place in the center? Normally, you'll place the least electronegative atom in the center. However, if there is carbon in your molecule, you'll want to place that in the center. Basically, you want to place the atom that can make the most bonds in the center. Step 3. Add electron pairs so that each terminal atom has an octet, which consists of 8 electrons. Notice that the electrons between the atoms are called bonding electrons, while the ones that are not sandwiched between the atoms are called non-bonding electrons. Step 4. Place any remaining electrons on the central atom. Since we're working with 18 electrons, we have already used up 16. So therefore, we have 2 more electrons left, and we're going to place that on the sulfur. Step 5. If there are not enough electrons to give the central atom an octet, then use one or more pairs of non-bonding electrons to form double or triple bond. So in our case, sulfur is lacking only 2 more electrons to become octet. So we can borrow any one pair of non-bonding electrons from either one of the oxygen atoms. It is important to note that you need to move 2 electrons together as a pair. And also, since we borrowed the non-bonding electrons from the oxygen on the right, they should be placed between sulfur and the right oxygen. Please note that you should not move 1 electron from each of the oxygen. So that's it. We have drawn the Lewis structure for SO2. Just to be extra sure, you can count the total number of electrons in the completed Lewis structure to make sure that it is equal to the number of valence electrons calculated in step 1. You could leave the answer as is with electron dots, or you can replace the bonding electrons with lines. Well, that's all. I hope you find this video useful in helping you draw Lewis structures.